A Ketogenic Diet to Lose Weight and Fight Metabolic Disease, Part 2. A Ketogenic Diet and Metabolic Diseases. Metabolic syndrome describes 5 common risk factors for obesity, type 2 diabetes, and heart disease: high blood pressure, high waist-to-hip ratio, excess belly fat, high levels of LDL, bad cholesterol, low levels of HDL, good cholesterol, high blood sugar levels. Many of these risk factors can be improved, or even eliminated, with nutritional and lifestyle changes. Insulin also plays an important role in diabetes and metabolic disease. Ketogenic diets are extremely effective for lowering insulin levels, especially for people with type 2 diabetes or prediabetes. One older study found that after only 2 weeks on a ketogenic diet, insulin sensitivity improved by 75% and blood sugar dropped from 7.5 mmol/L to 6.2 mmol/L. A 16-week study also found a 16% reduction in blood sugar levels. Additionally, 7 of the 21 participants were able to completely stop all diabetic medication. What's more, some studies in humans and animals have also found that the ketogenic diet could reduce levels of total cholesterol and triglycerides. However, note that most available research is only focused on the short-term effects of the ketogenic diet. In fact, some older studies suggest that the ketogenic diet may actually negatively affect heart health, particularly in children. Additionally, although research shows that saturated fat intake is not linked to a higher risk of heart disease directly, it may increase levels of LDL, bad cholesterol, which is a risk factor for heart disease. Furthermore, several studies also show that consuming high amounts of some types of fat may be associated with a higher risk of certain types of cancer. Therefore, more research is needed to determine how the ketogenic diet may affect health and disease long term. Bottom line, ketogenic diets can improve many aspects of the metabolic syndrome, a major risk factor for obesity, type 2 diabetes, and heart disease. Impact on metabolic disease. There are several key factors that explain the drastic effects of the ketogenic diet on markers of metabolic disease. These include fewer carbs. A high-carb diet can constantly elevate blood sugar and insulin levels, which can decrease the body's ability to use insulin efficiently. Decreased insulin resistance. Insulin resistance can cause health issues like inflammation, high triglyceride levels, and fat gain. Ketone bodies. Ketone bodies, molecules produced during ketosis, may help protect against some diseases, such as cancer, Alzheimer's, and epilepsy. Inflammation. The ketogenic diet can drastically reduce chronic inflammation, which is linked to metabolic syndrome and various diseases. Fat loss. This diet promotes the loss of body fat, especially unhealthy abdominal fat. Excess fat in the abdominal area is one of the criteria for metabolic disease. Restore normal insulin function. Research has shown that healthy insulin function can fight inflammation, while poor insulin function can increase it. As you can see, the combination of these factors plays a rather remarkable and important role in health and protection against disease. Bottom line, ketogenic diets may improve metabolic health by improving insulin function, lowering inflammation, and promoting fat loss, among others. How to follow a ketogenic diet? If you want to try a ketogenic diet, follow these basic rules. Eliminate carbs. Check food labels and aim for 20 to 50 grams of carbs or fewer per day. Stock up on staples. Buy meat, cheese, whole eggs, nuts, oils, avocados, oily fish, and cream, as these are now staples in your diet. Eat your veggies. Fat sources are high in calories, so base each meal on low-carb veggies to fill your plate and help keep you feeling full. Veggies will also provide fiber, which you'll no longer be getting from whole grains, beans, or legumes. Experiment. A ketogenic diet can still be interesting and tasty. You can even make ketogenic pasta, bread, muffins, brownies, puddings, ice cream, etc. Build a plan. It can be hard to find low-carb meals for when you're on the go. As with any diet, It's important to have a plan and go to snacks or meals. Find what you love. Experiment until you find the ultimate keto diet for you. Track progress. Take photos, measurements, and monitor your weight every 3 to 4 weeks. If progress stops, re-examine your daily intake. Make sure you're getting enough vegetables at every meal and keeping portion sizes moderate. Replace fluids. Make sure you're drinking enough water and getting proper amounts of electrolytes, like sodium, potassium, and magnesium. Be consistent. There's no shortcut to success. With any diet, consistency is the most important factor. You may also wish to monitor ketone levels in either urine or blood, since these let you know whether you're keeping carb levels down sufficiently to achieve ketosis. Based on current research, studies at my lab, and continuous testing with clients, anything over 0.5 to 1.0 millimoles/L demonstrates sufficient nutritional ketosis. Before switching to this type of diet or using any type of supplement, ask your doctor or a dietitian for advice. Bottom line, base most of your meals on low-carb veggies and high-fat meats, fish, or eggs. You may also wish to monitor your ketone levels. Should you try a ketogenic diet? No single diet is suitable for everyone, especially since individual metabolism, genes, body types, lifestyles, taste buds, and personal preferences differ. It can benefit people with obesity or who have a higher chance of developing metabolic syndrome, but it's not suitable for everyone. For example, it's not suitable for people with the following conditions: pancreatitis, liver failure, disorders of fat metabolism, carnitine deficiency, porphyrias, pyruvate kinase deficiency. There may also be some negative effects. When you first start the diet, you may experience flu-like symptoms, known as keto flu. This may include poor energy and mental function, increased hunger, sleep issues, nausea, digestive discomfort, and poor exercise performance. Researchers have not yet done enough long-term investigation to find out precisely what the long-term effects might be, but there may be a risk of kidney or liver problems. There's also a risk of dehydration, so you need to drink plenty of fluids, especially water, while following this diet. Always speak to a doctor before starting a ketogenic diet to ensure that it's safe and suitable for you. A ketogenic diet can also be hard to stick to. If you can't follow it but still like the idea of a low-carb diet, then carb cycling or a standard low-carb diet may be a better option for you. A ketogenic diet may also not be the best option for elite athletes or those wishing to build large amounts of muscle. Additionally, vegetarians or vegans may struggle with this diet, due to the key role meats, eggs, fish, and dairy play. Bottom line, the ketogenic diet can provide amazing results if you stick to it. However, it may not be the best option for everyone. Take home message. In order to get the most out of a ketogenic diet, you must eat high-fat foods and limit your carb intake to fewer than 30 to 50 grams per day. If you follow a ketogenic diet with medical supervision, it can help you lose weight, and it may enhance your overall health. It may reduce your risk for type 2 diabetes, obesity, and other aspects of metabolic disease. Before starting any new diet, remember to ask your doctor if it's a suitable option for you. What do you think? Let us know what you think below. We picked linked items based on the quality of products, and lists the pros and cons of each to help you determine which will work best for you. We partner with some of the companies that sell these products, and our partners may receive a portion of revenues if you make a purchase using the links below description.